Hello, pleasure to see you.
On an early morning stroll on Toronto's Danforth Avenue, Liberal leader Justin Trudeau talks to residents and shop owners who were impacted by the 2018 shooting here that left two dead and 13 others injured. It was a photo op ahead of a news conference to announce that a re-elected Liberal government would tighten gun laws.
Liberals are for tougher gun laws. Conservatives are for weaker gun laws.
Trudeau's staff says this event was always planned for this point in the campaign and was not intended to be a channel changer from Trudeau's brownface and blackface incidents, which was a hot topic with people Trudeau encountered on his Danforth stroll.
People held me accountable for what I did 20 years ago at Blue Heart.
But others were unhappy. One woman just off camera shouted out, "Hi, Mr. Blackface, nice to meet you." And at that press conference, more questions. For example, what's the story behind this video, the one obtained exclusively by Global News? What was he thinking? Why did he put on blackface? His answer?
It was a costume day for river guides on the whitewater rafting in the whitewater rafting operation that I worked at in the summer of between 92 and 94, roughly.
Yeah. Hey there.
I'm a little bit reluctant at the moment.
You do.
And so, at the end of week two, this campaign may hinge on voter perception of each leader's judgment and values. Liberals say Conservative leader Andrew Scheer must apologize for what they say was hurtful language he used in a 2005 speech in the House against same-sex marriage. Scheer, on Friday, continued to resist that idea.
Obviously, we had a debate on that issue. Canadians had their say. Our country has moved on, our society has moved on, and I've moved on.
The leaders' tours, including Trudeau's, now return to Ottawa for what the campaigns call a reset day. But for voters, it's a weekend to pause and reflect on one of the most remarkable weeks in Canadian politics.